bass.
Oh yes, big.
Big fish.
But no matter what you've caught, or even what you've seen, there is always a bigger fish, a tougher fish.
Shark, got it.
And it's out there. It's out there somewhere.
Developments in tackle and fishing technology has made it possible for the modern angler to catch fish with incredible efficiency.
Now I've got this reel preset to like a just sort of a slow jig, jig, jig install.
First drop! First drop! Unbelievable! I'm sold on this mechanical D-ing.
The glowing jig, and we've got a little strobing light on the bottom. Real tricky, eh? Particularly when you add it to an auto-jigging reel. Whew, echo.
But while we've got new technology, we shouldn't forget that much of the older, more simple techniques have worked for thousands of years.
Yep, got him on the hand line.
So we've set out from New Zealand's northernmost port to fish these incredibly productive inshore grounds for snapper, right out to the deep for the mighty marlin. And we'll be putting modern tackle and techniques up against the most primitive tackle and old school fishing tricks.
Now these days, there is so much technology that helps us catch fish. I've got a tackle box full of gear. This is just a sample. I mean, look at this fluorocarbon leader. It's invisible to fish. So this guy
I haven't even used. Yeah, we're ready with the latest technology from Shimano. Our energy rod, we've got Stella, we've got marlin on this. The real deep water for the big stuff. The electric reel again in the room. We've got my trusty twine. I've got loads of keys on it. It's capable of catching marlin. We've got this guy here, the tackle 15 year old swordfish on it. 130 pound line on it.
Unbelievable. And this guy here, the trusty bait runner, which has caught so many fish, not just for me, but for so many people. And Mark, our guest angler for the day, that's probably one of your first weapons. You know how to operate that one. But I'm gonna run you through how all of this tackle works, how all of the fishing technology works. We're gonna try and catch you as many fish as we possibly can on all of this gear. Whereas for me, on the other hand, all I'm gonna be able to use is this hand line and a bit of rag. And we're gonna see side by side how that goes.
Sweet, let's get into it.
On the bait runner here, we've just got a little wee deadly storm lure that will wiggle along for your kahawai, so yep. Run this one out a bit further. Meanwhile over here, I'll show you just how I plan to turn this little hand line here into something that can catch me, well, anything. With my bait here, which is this bit of rag. Well, it wasn't actually a rag, it was my daughter's bandana. But it was just the right colours that I wanted, so I grabbed it. So, sorry, Hannah. Little nick in the rag. Tear off a strip like so. Cut off, that's about the right length. Twist up the end. And we just poke it through the eye of the hook. We just twist it round. Now that's just gonna wiggle on through the water. And that's going to look like a bait fish and get him on the old hand line. That's the theory, at least.
Here you go, look at that, eh?
That just looks like a bait fish to me. Now it's right here in the white water. And it's that turbulent white water which gives the kahawai a bit of cover, because the water's so clear here, they can't really hide anywhere to predate on their prey, so you got all the swell coming in, crashing against the coast, and that creates this white water, which in turn, I was just talking long enough to get a blowhole and it never happened. Oh, now it goes. Hey. Oh, yeah, right. I've got faith in the rag, I've got faith in it.
My plan is pretty simple. I'm trying to use my piece of rag to catch some kahawai. They make excellent bait. I've caught my biggest snapper and kingfish with kahawai, and I've caught plenty of marlin with them too. On the other side of the boat, Mark's also trying for kahawai, only he's got a fancy soft plastic bait that's impregnated with fish pheromones. But the first fish to show up are chasing my rag.
Oh yeah, there they are, look. Kingy's on it.
Ah, I don't want a kingy. I need some kahawai for bait.
Yep.
You've got a bite? Find it in, brother. Okay, well that looks like it might be one to the lure. Alright, I'll get the net for you. Okay, just bring him up, mate. I'll get him in the net. Oh, yep, there we go. On the soft bait, that's a mint-sized live bait. And so you're sorted for a live bait, and you've got dead bait, and you've got lures. I've still got my rag. Right, we'll get him in the livey tank, eh? Yeah. Okay, I'll get back up to speed. We'll head back around there. We've got a kahawai.
I need to catch a kahawai with my piece of rag because I have no bait, no lures, and no plan B.
Shot on the rag. Oh, I had another bite. Come on, don't be a dick.
I had a couple of bites then. Hope he didn't rip my bit of rag off. Oh, I had another bite.
Did you get any bites on that one?
Yeah.
Oh, got him. I got him. Oh, yeah. Oh, a bit of raggage.
So if you wind your lure in, you might hook up on the way in.
Sweet. This is all we need to kick us off. Just a bit of bait. He's on over there as well on the lure. Oh, yeah. Mini marlin. Oh, no!
Bro, where was my net? I netted yours. You've got a bite?
Yep. Just check this one, mate.
Oh, yep.
Yep, got him on the raggage. Oh, and on the... I've got both hand lines hooked up. That's getting greedy now, eh? Here, move your flash fishing gear out of my way, bro.
I lost one.
Lost them both. Man, the rag's working, though. I'm getting the bites.
Oh,
you lost them too, bro.
I'm not concentrating.
Okay. Oh, you're kidding me. And the other hand line, got him on too. You beauty. Hey, you're trying to rob my fish. That's the hand line one. With the old lasso. Bit of a trick I learned back in the day. Come on, make him count. Yes, I am in action. This is all I need for a start. I need a few more and I can turn one of these guys into just about any fish you could imagine. In the live bait tank.
Beautiful.
To be fair, it's been pretty even really, the number of bites. Hey, rags rag to lure. This goes to show you. Fish are dumb. Just gotta do the basics. Man, they're just honey little kahawai too. Got him. We're doing it, we're making bait. Yeah. Nah, mate, all good.
There we go. Bit of rag. It's just too irresistible.
It's the simplicity of it that I love. Going there with your mates, you're looking good.
That's how we did it back in the day. Heading out fishing with just a hand line and a piece of rag, coming back with a bin full of fish. That's what I hope to do today, except the fish are gonna be. Who knows, mate? Maybe even a marlin. Maybe.
Yeah, my boy. That's what we do with the kahawai. How are you getting on there? Keep winding. Oh, boy. Oh, my boy. On a jig.
Uh-oh.
This could be a marlin.
So to catch up with the latest tips and techniques, as well as our latest fishing action, check out ultimatefishing.tv and download the Ultimate Fishing app so wherever you go, you've got access to our entire catalogue of tips, rigs, techniques and location information. And it's all available free at ultimatefishing.tv. We're out in the far north of New Zealand, where I'm putting my hand line and rag lure up against a boatload of modern tackle and lures. I've executed the first part of the plan and caught some fresh bait on my rag lure. Now, we're heading a little further up the coast where we drop anchor and send out the burley for the first hand line versus rod and reel challenge. It's snapper time.
Well, Mark's got his lovely Southern Baits pilchards, and we know how good those work. But fear not, I've got faith in the fresh kahawai. Let's take the fillets off the kahawai. Now these big ones, I don't worry about scaling them because I'm gonna take the skin off. And that is because fresh kahawai is really tough. You don't want it to bind the hooks up. So fill it off just like that. And just looking at that, I might point out that you can eat kahawai. It is actually beautiful when it's fresh like this. Very underrated. So you don't always have to catch kahawai, use it for bait to catch snapper, kingfish, marlin, tuna or whatever. You can go straight from catching it on your rag to eating it.
Snapper are the most iconic fish in New Zealand, loved for their great eating quality and revered as a tough sport fish. Because once hooked, they're a fish that will power their way to the reef and break your line. But first things first, I've got to entice one to eat my bait.
And I've got every faith that that is going to work superbly well. Yeah, at least. Yeah, go 50.
BMC short set.
I got him, mate. On the big fresh slab, eh? The first slab that went out for that fresh kahawai. It's a snapper. Oh, shivers. I might need that net there, Mark. Jesus, oh, guy's hurting my hands. Oh, burning, burning, burning. Hey. Good burn. And that's what we do with the kahawai, boys. Yeah, my boy. That's what we do with the kahawai. Hey, you can eat fresh kahawai, or you can use it for fresh bait, chuck it on your hand line, and there you go, that boy there started with a rag. Oh, you got one on?
Yeah, I think so. Yep, yep.
Oh, yeah, he's got him as well. Okay, this one's going in the bin, bro. Okay. This snapper's gonna go to the light, and in behind the eye. And now, all that remains to be done is to get that guy on ice and get another bit of fresh kahawai out on the handle. Okay, how are you going there with that fish? Oh, no, it's a kingy.
Oh,
and then, best way to deal with these guys, oh, look at that, he's only just hooked. Is just, oh, yay, that felt nice. I was gonna say, I'll follow my own advice, is tuck them under your wing. Upside down, they calm down. Hook out into the water.
Hey,
you just smoked away, eh? Gonna go for a nice big hook. The 9-bar OVMC short set. Right, now Mark, this is what I was getting to. These anchovies. They make the wicked chunks, so you just like MasterChef, mate, just chop them up. And we'll just keep those snapper feeding in our trail, mate. Technically, you've got to do it. You've got to do it because I've got to just use, I didn't catch those anchovies on my rag, mate, so you're gonna have to, yeah.
Make no mistake, this is a challenge. Mark with his technology versus me with a hand line. But for now, we'll work together to burly up, and soon we'll see if it's the hand line or the tackle that comes out on top. But first, we need the snapper to show up.
There's gonna be a beast here somewhere, eh?
Hit him, hit him, hit him.
Yeah, boy, that's a biggie. Keep him moving now. Oh, I got you to ground. Bro, that was, like I said, bro, you're gonna get your 20 pounder today. Well, you hooked it, mate. You can lead a horse to water, eh? Oh, here we go, yep. Oh, yes, this is a biggie. Come on, get me the reef. Oh, on you. Oh, yeah, boy. Oh, we both got biggies on. Oh, yeah, keep them moving, brother. Football drag. Be some kingies coming through. Hopefully, you got yours as a snapper. Hopefully, mine's a kingie.
Oh, the one with the, keep him away from the motors, bro.
Yep.
That's a snapper, mate, this is the donk. Right, I've got, oh, I thought I had the big snapper on, it was a king. Okay, I'm just gonna dispatch this one because there's some big snappers down there. We've had big snapper running off the ground. Oh, you keep him moving, bro. Oh, it's nice just having one hook, I tell you, because you can't hook yourself on the other one. Okay, I'll untangle that mess later. And, just keep pumping them up. Does it feel real bumpy? Yeah, could be a king. If it's a snapper, it's the one, brother. It's the one we come for if it's a snapper. See, there was those little anchovy chunks. I'll keep a few going while we're waiting. We'll just keep everyone interested. I think it's a king either way that they're swimming, though. Yeah, it's a king. Oh, it was a bit of excitement. Mind you, you shouldn't scoff when you're hooking up like this. Amazing the scrap you get out of, eh? Okay, and we'll dispatch him. Ready, go. Okay, beautiful. Okie doke. Well, that gave you the fight of a 20-pound snapper. Just got to get the actual 20-pound snapper now. Well done, brother. And then, oh yeah, see, now you got it. So now with these smaller kahawai, hole, fill it. I can leave the skin on, the skin's much softer. Just pop the hook through just once like that. Fish don't know what a hook are, they're stupid, so might as well have the hook exposed so it can work properly. And that'll just float its way down in that burley, and hopefully into the path of a snapper that's already down there, just working his way up the burley, chomp, chomp, chomp. In fact, we know there's one down there because our cameraman's seen him. Bit of behind the scenes there for you. I can feel some little guys trying to eat this big fillet. But what happens so often is the little guys will get in there and they'll be crowding around, nibbling at it, and that'll get the attention of the big boy, and he'll just come over and smash it out of the way. Or like maybe just now. Look at that, something's got it. Something's got it. Yep, I've got him. Oh. It's all this big fillet, man. I want to get this fish really bad. Oh, yeah. Big head shakes. Okay, bro, there's my bait. Look at that, the big chunk of kahawai still there. And that guy's going right in the neck there, eh? Hey! Right, thank you very much, bro, for the help. Oh, this one, look, he's that big hook, just like I said. Whoa, settle down, buddy. Because I just hauled him on that pen line, he's going to be healthy as. Can't be long on this because I want to get a photo and let this guy go. Because that's a good one for the old hand line, that big-headed buffer right there. Okay, I'll turn him to the light. Sweet, okay, he's going home. He's going home. Okay. Woohoo! All of this fun started with that. Bit of rag and a handline. Beauty.
The old school handline has easily won the snapper fishing. But from here on, we'll be targeting bigger fish, and next is kingfish.
Okay, mate, you flick out that pilly, and I'm gonna go for one of my rag caught live baits. Okay, and there's a nice fresh kahawai on the handline. Out she goes for the change of light. Give those burley bags a jiggle. By the time we don't take any back with us, we'll empty them. Oh yeah, there they are, look. Kingies on it. Kingies all over the livey. Oh, they're just not big enough. Eat it. They can't even pop the balloon off. Look at them. That's all right. All that activity of all those kingies racking up all those little rats, they might just get that big one along and he'll come and boff, knock those little guys out of the way. And I will be getting some line burn trying to stop those guys getting into the reef. Just as we're coming up to this change of light period. We're toughing it out, Mark.
Doing good.
It's not always like you see on telly, babe. Oh, where's my fishing rods, Mark?
Bloody wind, not funny.
Is that a bite, was it? Tighten up, bro, tighten up. You've not gotten enough drag. Give it a wind. We're just talking about packing up in Boomfa. Hopefully it's a snapper, not one of those rat kingies.
Yeah, it is a snapper.
Okay. Bring them on up, mate. Bring them on up, nice and smooth. Oh,
yes, just a nice heater, that one. That one's coming home with us.
That one's coming home with us. Well done. Oh, I think it was all that.
It's a big day, brother.
Hey, we've had to work for it, but hey, this could be the beginning, and there's always tomorrow. Okay, give that one the spike treatment. Well done, bro. We weren't quite sure whether we were going to go for a shake.
I was going, it's the bro size. No, coming back, coming on. At least let him go.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, this is what we come for.
Be the big hooker, brother. Yeah, just keep working him. Oh, yo, he's going to have a chew on cane.
He's stalking you, bro. Yeah, no, that's right, just keep facing him.
Cane! I'm in the far north of New Zealand fishing with Mark Wirihana. He's a fan who we selected from our Facebook page to come fishing with us. Now, he's on my boat and is using all of my state-of-the-art fishing gear, while I, on the other hand, have just a hand line and a piece of rag. So first off, I turned my rag into a lure so I could catch some bait.
This is all I need for a start. I need a few more and I can turn one of these guys into just about any fish you can imagine.
So far, my hand line has delivered the goods, and my primitive gear is easily keeping up with Mark and the modern fishing tackle.
All of this fun started with that. Bit of rag and a hand line. Yummy.
Today, I'm looking to go even bigger, so we're heading out wide. But first, I need to get the rag back out and catch myself some bait.
Well, today, we're starting our day just as we did yesterday. I've got my hand line here, a wee bit of rag. Mark's got a couple of lures out, and we're trying to replenish our bait stocks. Although today, once we catch our kahawai, we're gonna take them way out wide for something big. I just said big like that, just to leave it wide open. Could be a big kingy, could be a puka. Don't wanna jinx it. Oh, there you go this morning. Rag one, lures nil. How's your lures going over there, bro?
Start selling these.
Hey.
Oh yeah, that's a nice little bait. That's a nice bait, that one.
Hey.
One for the rag.
Lifting off that lid for us, please, bro.
Thank you.
Right. Let's go. We're done.
Well, I mean, what did you end up doing there, mate?
I ended up having a bit of a trouble.
You had a bit of a mischief there?
Yeah.
What happened?
Oh, I broke off the lure. The lure was just working so hard, it just broke it off. They were just attacking it, smashing it to bits.
Oh, I see, yeah.
30 pound line, eh?
Yeah.
There's a bit of a saying, fish don't break lines, anglers break lines.
It's all part of the apprenticeship. Okie doke, Mark. Now, have you used one of these guys before?
No, I haven't had a crick, mate.
Okay, mate. We are in 120 metres of water, so it's pretty deep to be learning to jig. So I've gone for the big 400 gram jig. I figure a big fella like yourself will like working the big one. We're just going to be sort of reversing the boat up here into the tide. I've never fished here before, but there's a bit of foul. Some sign in there on the Furuno sounder. As soon as it hits the bottom, you want to get in gear because so you don't get hung up in the coral. And then, so lifting with this hand. So your two hands are sort of trying to work in unison. There you go.
Cheers, brother.
Yeah, so away you go. Well, while Mark's jigging away there, this is the big moment that I've been waiting for anyway. Getting this bad boy out. Out of retirement, the trusty old electric fence reel. Awesome. Well, right there, I've got a couple of chunks of my freshly caught kahawai. Big 32 ounce lump of lead. And I've got that attached to my trusty electric fence reel hand line. And for those of you that don't know, my electric fence reel hand line,
it's got a bit of history, and while this is dropping down to the bottom, I might be able to tell you about them, if I can remember. First off was marlin on a hand line, and that came about when I decided to catch a marlin on a budget of just 25 bucks. And I found my old electric fence reel here out the back of my shed. For a lure, I used the broken end of a big ballpoint pen. And I used that lure to catch a tuna. Marlin comes along, eats my tuna, and geez, it jumped all over the show. I actually thought the electric fence reel was gonna fly to bits at one stage.
The electric fence reel gonna be able to handle this.
But I got the marlin in, and the camera crew had followed me around for 3 days, were pretty hungry, so they wanted to keep it, so I thought, fair enough. Dragged it on board, just about filled my dinghy up,
yes!
And I took some great pleasure taking that one in, because there was only one marlin caught on the coast that day, and it was caught on this guy, my trusty electric fence reel. Yeah, I took it all the way to Vanuatu, and I used the chief's little outrigger canoe, and went out and caught a dogtooth tuna that fed the whole village. I hand-lined in greymouth out of my little wee boat, and that was 100 k's or 60 nautical miles offshore. Hand-lined a bluefin tuna, and I swore I was never going to do it again after I tore the muscle off of my elbow.
Okay, we'll grab a gaff because it's just about ripping my bloody arm off.
I took the electric fence reel across to Cairns to try and catch a giant black marlin, so it's been there. Niue, I took it out on an outrigger canoe again in Niue, a bucker. And I've got a yellowfin tuna on a hand line there. Just out here, not far from here actually, I hand lined a swordfish. And oh man, big one. Leapt all around the show and ended pretty dramatically when a giant Marco shark came along and smoked it. Nova Scotia. Giant bluefin tuna broaching out of the surface, smashing our baits. My heart was just about in my mouth, freaking out that I was actually going to try and stop one of these things on a hand line. And managed an 800 pounder, and that was the biggest fish to date on the hand line.
Get on that, cowboy!
So that was the best I can recall for the benefit of you that don't know the history of this mighty electric fence reel that's been catching fish for over 10 years now. But today I'd just like to catch a half hooker. And then if we can do that, well then maybe we'll head out and try for something big and fancy. But a feeder pooker would be good right now.
Yeah.
Well, do you get a shot then?
Yep.
Oh, he's got him
yep.
on.
Yep.
So there you go, the jig, brother.
On a Bentos jig. A couple of drops over the spot then. Yep.
Well, the exciting thing is, bro, in this depth of water, it could be a pooker, it could be a kingie. That's why I like coming out to see sort of deeper reefs. Never fished here before.
Love that.
Is it taking line?
Yeah.
How much?
About 5 meters off the bottom.
Oh, it was 5 meters off the bottom when you hooked it.
Yeah.
Could be the big pooker, brother. Don't let him get to ground, bro. Don't let him get to ground. It's a good fish, bro.
Yeah.
Well, did you get a shot then? Oh, he's got him
yep.
on.
Yep.
So there you go, the jig, brother. The exciting thing is, bro, in this depth of water, it could be a pooker, it could be a kingie. That's why I like coming out to see sort of deeper reefs. Never fished here before.
Love that.
Is it taking line?
Yeah.
How much?
About 5 meters off the bottom.
Oh, it was 5 meters off the bottom when you hooked it.
Yeah.
Could be the big pooker, brother. Yeah, just keep working them. Oh, you're puffing there, bro.
Don't do that to me on
the
screen.
You're puffing. Just. You're puffing.
Jigging is not for the obese marlin.
Hey. Hey, leave our plus size fans alone, eh? Just keep everything tight, mate, because with the jig, unlike a hook, will hold in nicely.
Yep.
It's got that big heavy jig there that it's rattling around, and any slack line, don't let him get to ground, bro. Don't let him get to ground. That's a good fish, bro. I'm just going to tighten that up a little bit if you can.
Yep.
Oh, you've got heaps of drag on. That's a good fish. Okay, just little short pumps. Smooth lift.
Yeah.
Don't lock too much on the thumb.
Yeah.
So just nice and smooth lifts. That's a big pig, whatever you've got on there, boy. That's the big pig. Please stay connected. Woo! I wonder if I should be pulling my hand line up. I've only just got to the bottom, so we don't want you to tangle, eh?
Okay.
I will, see? Nice and smooth, bro. Let's make this one count, brother. Let's make it count.
Whatever it is, it's a good fish. That's the thing, you don't get sharks on the jigs, you don't get rubbish fish. How are you getting on there, bro?
Yeah, with my brother, getting it some more back.
That's the way, just keep going. See, the good thing about catching a fish in this depth of water is you get to enjoy the fight so much longer. You're pulling my rig up now as well.
Yeah, it's at the front of the boat, mate, it's up.
Is it floating?
Yeah.
A big hooker. Keep everything tight. Oh, yes! Keep winding. Oh, boy! Oh, my boys! Oh, my boy, on a jig! Oh, hey, look, I've got it on my hand line. Okay, the gaff. Okay, your first time jigging, was it?
Yeah, brother.
Okay, yeah, that's not too bad.
Dead drop.
You know, I might need a little bit of help lifting this sucker in. Now, you said you wanted to take a feed home, bro. I think we're good for a feed. This one's going to have to come in over the back. Oh. Oh, that was worth getting ragdolled by the big bear.
Oh. Look, my hook has gone right through the ring on your jig. What are the odds?
That's like a one in a billion.
That's why I helped you pull it up. So technically, bro, this is my fish.
That was really powerful, eh?
Oh, yeah.
I didn't think I was going to get it off the rail. Like, I was just sweating bullets.
Seriously, bro, it's like the fish version of you.
Handsome.
Big and ugly. Okay, bro. Right, we're going to get this big bad boy on board. So just walk him around the back because we're not going to be able to lift him over the side. Yeah, I've got the gaff. Okay, you come around this side of me here and grab that gaff. Just got to be real careful with it. Okay, go. Just be careful as it comes down. Oh! Oh! It is as big as you. You know what the trouble with this is going to be? Holding it up for the photo. Oh man, I haven't seen one that big in a long time. It ain't fitting in our icy tech, bro, so what we want to do, because this is a pristine eating fish, is get him in this bag and then we'll fill it up with salt ice. So it's gonna be a bit of an effort. But of course, with any fish, you've got to treat them with respect, particularly a big old fish like this. It is gonna feed so many people and we don't want to be leaving it out in the sun because we've still got plenty more fishing to do. Right, okay. Well, I really was hoping that I was going to catch my first harp hooker on the electric fence reel, and we've got plenty of sign here, but it would be pretty irresponsible of me to drop down a bait again, given that we've got so much fish here to take home. So, Mark, we're going to have to go after another species, a sport fish, perhaps, you know, where we let them go. It's like a kingy, or how does a marlin sound?
Sounds pretty good to me, mate.
Well, I might have to go over old ground, catch another bait on my bit of rag, hook it up to the old electric fence reel here, and meanwhile you'll get to use the flash gear, the old Telica 50, and you'll have the marlin lures and all the fancy gears, and we'll see how we get on. Marlin time. Headed out offshore a wee bit, found a bit of reasonably blue water. We've put out a couple of marlin lures for Mark on our Shimano Telica reels, but I still need to catch a bait, and my ideal bait would be a skipjack tuna. So I've gone and got my little bit of rag, and I've just added to it the end of a broken Bic ballpoint pen, and that's going to be my tuna lure. Keep an eye out for any fins. When I'm out trying to catch a marlin in the wide blue ocean, it's a big area out here, so my Freno electronics really my go-to instrument for finding signs of fish. Now, first thing I'm looking at is temperature. Our temperature was 21.3 degrees a moment ago. It's jumped up almost a degree. And on this side here, I've got my range set to just looking at the top 100 meters, there's a whole pile of bait fish. This is, oh, hang on, speaking of a whole pile of bait fish, look out the window here. There you go. My eyes as well. While you've got this, you've got to actually keep your head up as well, because there's, you can see the surface rippling over here. That looks like skipjack tuna, and they'll be feeding on this bait, and they'll be on this temperature break. And look at that, that temperature's dropped just in the time I've been speaking to you. You want a temperature break, and that is because the bait fish don't like going through sudden changes in temperature, so they get herded up against it. They ball up there, and the marlin and the skipjack tuna that I can see fizzing on the surface, this is where they feed. And if there's skipjack tuna here, that is candy for marlin, and this is where they'll be. It's gotta catch me a bait, and I'll be psyched sitting here on my hand line with a live skippy out. Gotta catch him first. There he goes, and on the handline down here. Woohoo! Oh no! Busted. Oh, I just got another bite. Look at them chasing the rag right here. There we go, the old Fruno led us right to him. That's been happening all day. I start talking about something, boom, and it happens. See? People say, oh, you made that up, you doctored it. Nah, bro, look at that. Nice work. Okay, when you get your skipper in, you hold him upside down and it just gets him to chill a wee bit. We'll pop that fine specimen there into the tuna tube, and I'll see if I can get one on my rag, so that way I've got a bait too. Okay, let's go, get us moving. Come on, buddies. Yeah, look, they're on my lure, they're on it. Look, they're all over it. They're all over it. Look, I'm chasing my lure. Slow down. Got him! Oh. Ah, burn. Yeah. Oh. Nothing like a little bit of line burn. Oh, nice one, bro.
Cheers, brother.
That one can go in the bin. We've only got one tuna tube working.
Yep.
I want to get your one out of there. And if I can get this guy in, he's going to... Oh, no, you're kidding! Okay, go around again. Here we go. Look, they're right on it, Yeah, got him. Whoa. Here he is. Bullet of a fish, the skipjack tuna, and he fell to my rag. We're in business now, mate. Hey, the old rag's doing the damage.
The skipjack tuna is another fish that's fallen victim to the deadly combination of my hand line and a piece of rag. And now we're all set for the final challenge, to catch a sport fish, like a kingfish, or a big game fish, like a marlin or shark. It's time to get our baits out.
Bait's in the water, that's your one there, so you just come and hold on to that, mate. If it gets a bite, let it go. And I'm gonna chuck out one of my baits that I caught on my rag on my hand line and see if I can complete the rag deal by getting a sport fish from starting off with a rag. I better put my gloves on in anticipation of that big bite. Oh, you've been bit.
We've put my hand line and a piece of rag up against modern fishing tackle. And so far, it's been pretty even.
Yes, I am in action. I am in business.
The bait fishing was even. I took out the snapper with my hand line. And Mark easily won in the deep water with a massive bass. So to break the deadlock, we're after a big game fish, and we've each got one bait out. Mark's bait is attached to the latest Shimano tackle, and mine to a hand line, wound on to an old fence reel I found in my farm shed.
The old electric fence reel. I see it's just hanging in there, holding together. It's got a little bit of rust. It's been doing it a while now, but I just want one more fish for it, trying to make it relive its glory days. Although eventually it's going to get a fish that's going to get the better of it, it's going to fly to bits, it's getting a bit old. A bit like me. I always feel like I'm fishing when I've got a, like I'm holding a line, I can feel a nice bait. Oh, you've been bit.
Let it go, let it go, let it go, let it go, let it go. Something ate there.
Yeah, something's taking it, man.
Let it run if it takes it.
Yep.
Keep letting it go. Yep. Slowly push the drag up, slowly push the drag up, slowly.
Yep, back down.
Give it a crank again, give it a crank, give it a hard crank. Let it go again, eh? Might have got your bait off this time. Now all the way in, it's eating your bait, it's taking it off. Something's on my bait now, it's come onto my bait. See if I can do it without screwing it up. Oh, this could be a marlin. Is there any teeth marks? There's not teeth marks. Nah, be a marlin then. He might come back and eat my bait. He's only plucked that off your hook. Yep, my bait's freaking out on me. He's got my bait, okay. Oh, jeez, I think he just plucked it then. Plucked it off then, Anna. I've got him.
Oh, fuck, you smoke! Oh, no!
Look, it's a shark, he's got it. Look at him. Marco. Where's that Marco? Come pinching your face. Look at him, he's right there. Oh, Marco, eh? Oh, that was a bit of excitement. Look at him, always looking at the camera. They get fired up on the old camera. Oh, hey. Just see, we were doing the same thing. Talk about it. We thought, oh yeah, here comes the marlin, Marco Sharp. It is pretty cool to see these guys though. It is pretty cool to see them, except when they're eating my swordfish. That's when it's not so cool. Fair's fair, he gets a feed. We get a bit of footage and a little bit of a laugh.
Well, our marlin turned out to be a feisty Marco Sharp. So it looks like we're gonna have to call the handline versus tackle challenge a draw.
Yes.
Though I've got to say, I've enjoyed fishing with our guest Mark. He's been a great sport. Together, we've shown that we can catch plenty of fish with nothing more than a rag and a hand line.
It's been awesome to go out with you and have a true adventure. Probably the best fish I'll ever catch in my whole life, bro. Mean.
Good on ya.
But we still have this small matter of a hungry Marco shark swimming around the boat. And it wouldn't be ultimate fishing if we didn't send Kane in to get some footage. And I might just tease the shark a bit to keep him fired up for the camera.
Oh, he's gonna have a chew on Kane. Is that rolling on that one? He was keen, eh?
Yeah, he's keen, all right.
Don't let it scratch that lens on that camera. Yeah, no, that's right, just keep facing him. Oh, ominously circling around Kane. Oh, hey, he's stalking you, bro. he's tracking, he's hunting you down. Yeah, situation vacant. We're looking for a new underwater cameraman. Kane! Well, if you've enjoyed this episode, but you want more, it's a good thing, because we've got more action, including this swordfish that I'm hooked up to right now, as well as tips, tricks, everything from short videos to full episodes, and it's all available free right now on the Ultimate Fishing app or at ultimatefishing.tv.